The person who registers for the Qlik Cloud subscription is a service account owner and tenant admin. As a tenant admin, you have access to the management console where you can configure and manage the Qlik Cloud tenant for your organization. In the home section, administrators can monitor purchased and used amounts of different capacities. The section gives you an overview of the consumption of user allocations, data capacity, reloads, and other capacity-based resources. It also shows a list of the capabilities that are enabled with your subscription and the limits on the capabilities. In the Users section, you can invite new users by email and activate or disable existing users. When you invite a user to the tenant by email, they sign in with their Qlik ID, but you can also set up other identity providers. When a user joins the tenant, you assign them professional entitlement or analyzer entitlement. Analyzer entitlement is intended for users who only consume sheets and apps created by others. A user with analyzer entitlement cannot create, edit, or publish sheets or apps, but can create stories, bookmarks, and snapshots based on data in apps that are shared with them. This user can also generate on-demand apps, print objects, stories, and sheets, and export data from an object to Microsoft Excel. Professional entitlement is intended for users who will create content. A user with professional entitlement can create shared spaces, create, edit, and publish sheets or apps, and create and edit alerts. In the Settings section, you can enable automatic assignment of professional entitlement or analyzer entitlement to users when they log in to Qlik Cloud. Once the user you've invited logs in, you can change entitlements manually in the Users section. In the Users section, you can also change security roles for individual users. Security roles provide a set of tenant-level permissions to users and administrators beyond the general permissions granted by the user entitlements. By default, authentication is completed by Qlik using your Qlik ID, but you can set up other identity providers. In the Identity Provider section, you can manage the identity providers used in the tenant. There are several types of identity providers to choose from. As a tenant administrator, you can also create and maintain shared, managed, and data spaces. In a managed space, only the space owner and target app consumers can open the apps. No other users can open the apps in the managed space unless they have been given permission. Shared spaces are used by a defined group of users to develop apps. Apps inside a shared space are only accessible by the group of users who have access to the space. Data spaces are governed areas of your Qlik Cloud tenant that are used to create and store data projects in Qlik Cloud data integration. Selecting a space, you can edit the space or change the space owner. You can add space members by clicking the Manage Members button. When you add members to a space, you can assign space roles to them. Each space role is a set of permissions that define what members can do in the space. As a tenant admin, you can manage all alerts created in the tenant and enable or disable them. In the Subscription section, you can enable or disable individual subscriptions, delete a subscription, or change the owner of a subscription. In the Schedule section, you can view and delete reload schedules of the app. In the Events section, you can follow up on events in your system and get information about the event type and the user who initiated the event. On the Apps section under Source, you can move apps between self-managed spaces. This includes personal or shared spaces. You can also change the owner of apps and delete them. Under Published, you can change the app space between managed spaces, or you can delete the app. In the Data Connections section, you can manage data connections. The Data Connections page shows data connections in the tenant with name, owner, space, type, and dates for update and creation. You can move data connections from a shared to a managed space and from a managed space to a shared space. A tenant admin, analytics admin, or data admin can move a data connection from any of the space types to which they have access to their personal space. In the automation section, you can see an overview of the basic information about each automation, like whether the automation is enabled or disabled, the status of the last automation run, and the automation run mode. You can get more information about the individual automation by clicking on the arrow. This table shows a history of automation runs, the status of each run, and the run duration. You can enable or disable automations, delete them, or change the owner. In the AutoML section, you can find the currently running and queued jobs for model training, deployment, and prediction generation. Here, you can cancel jobs. In the generic link section, you can make external resources available in the cloud. You might have apps in a deployment of ClickSense Enterprise on Windows, or useful ClickSense mashups that are relevant to members of specific spaces. You can either create a single link or upload a CSV file containing the generic links. In the Extensions section, you can add and manage third-party extensions. In the Themes section, you can upload your custom themes. In the API Keys section, the tenant admin manages system integration through API keys and web integrations. By default, API keys are disabled. To enable them, go to the Settings section. You can use API keys to authenticate users, developers, or other programs. The Content Security Policy section helps to detect and mitigate certain types of attacks, including cross-site scripting and data injection attacks. In the OAuth section, tenant admins can administer OAuth clients. In the web section, you can create and manage web integrations. Web integrations let you create an allow list of domains that can access the tenant. When a web integrated domain requests a connection with the tenant, for example, an embedded visualization, Qlik Cloud checks the allow list of approved domains. A webhook is an HTTP callback that passes system event information about events in Qlik Cloud tenants to other applications. The application that receives the outbound webhook information can use it to trigger other tasks in the workflow. The Settings section is where you can view your tenant information and enable or disable many of the features and functionalities in Qlik Cloud. Here you can configure a tenant alias, enable or disable on-demand data, enable or disable specific features, enable or disable dynamic user assignment, enable or disable API keys, configure an email server, enable or disable chart sharing and subscriptions, enable offline usage for mobile, change the key management service, and set values for token expiration. Data Gateway provides a secure means of accessing or moving firewalled data for use in Qlik Cloud. There are two types of gateways, one for analytics services known as Qlik Data Gateway Direct Access, and the other for data integration services known as Qlik Data Gateway Data Movement. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.